23rd Psalm. And it's a wonderful scripture because it talks about the Lord leading us through life. You know, sometimes we just don't know what to do. Sometimes we don't know what's going to happen. But if we open our hearts to the Lord and let Him be our shepherd, He will direct our steps. He'll provide for us. He'll give us rest. He'll just be with us. And even though, well, I'm going to read it. How's that? 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for His namesake. And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for Thou art with me. Thy rod and Thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord. It said He'll provide for me, He'll give me rest, He'll even help me walk in the right path. He gives me His wisdom. And what is wonderful, even though I go through the valley of the shadow of death, do you realize to be a shadow, there has to be a light? And Jesus is the light of the world, and He even walks with us through that valley of the shadow of death, and we walk in His light. In His light. Isn't that wonderful? And then surely goodness and mercy shall follow me, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, this is my privilege. This is really a privilege for me. Because when the kids were little, I'm speaking of Chris and Vicki and Steve, my Steve, and I guess, Russ, you're a little older. Don't you know wisdom comes with
you
that?
You said it's
cool. Anne was younger, so yeah. I really remember the three the best. But, I mean, they had some quite experiences playing. Yeah, so we won't go into those. But, so when they came to visit with me on Monday night, I was just so blessed. They even came to Wyoming to visit Ozzie and I when we were out there, and we took a drive into part of the Black Hills. And so it was just fun, and I want to tell you, I was totally impressed with Benny. I mean, Benny's a quiet guy, but you don't know all that was going on in his heart and in his life. And so when they were sharing with me all these memories, they said, Dad never grew up. And do you know I love that? Because I no scripture says that the other part of the rainbow is around the throne of God. So maybe, you know, he's seen that rainbow. I just think it's just awesome, the family. And so if you want to follow with me in the funeral folder, I'm going to read the obituary. Preceding Ben in death were his parents, Charles and Margaret Burroughs, wife Marilyn Burroughs, granddaughter Teresa Crossman, three brothers, Gerald Burroughs, Francis Burroughs, and Jerry Burroughs, a brother-in-law, Max Livingston, two sisters-in-laws, Frieda Burroughs and Rexine Burroughs. Left to cherish his memory are his son, Russ Burroughs, and his wife, Debbie of Shenandoah, daughter Vicki Major and her husband, Tom of Shenandoah, son Chris Burroughs and Carolyn, I'm sorry. Did I say that right, Carolyn?
You're right.
No, I didn't. Wasn't right.
Karen.
Well, there she is right there.
Everybody says
the one I thought I could pronounce. Karen.
Okay.
Well, oh, that's Karen. Okay. Now, where am I? Oh, here I am. Of Omaha, Nebraska. Daughter Ann Smith and Dave of Villisca, Iowa. Ten grandchildren. Kara, Zach, Wig of Monroe, Iowa. Jen Corbin Moody of Morrell, Nebraska. Brad Major of Shenandoah, Iowa. Megan Drew Wilson of Clarinda, Iowa. Nathan and his wife Tanya Burroughs of Omaha. Dwayne Burroughs of Kansas City. Celeste and her husband Chase Wallace of Griswold, Iowa. Caden and Chelsea Burroughs of Omaha, Nebraska. Danny Treat, fiance Chris. Seven great grandchildren, Ellis and Hazel Wig. Maddox and Maverick Wilson. Autumn and Trinity Burroughs. And Aubrey Treat and Charlotte Ditmars and Hank of Farragut. Other friends and many relatives. Okay. I knew who the kids were. Where are the grandkids? Raise your hand. Okay. Where are the great grandkids? There you go. Okay, the book of Psalms says children are a reward from the Lord. Okay. It also says in Proverbs 17 chapter, that the children's children, or grandchildren, are a crown to the elderly, the mature, whatever nice word you want to put in there. And then the children's children are a crown to the grandparents. So great-grandchildren are really a crown. You see, grandchildren bring sparkle to your life. You know, you have fun with them. They go home. Brightness and joy. And great-grandchildren, wow, you put people's eyes out. You're so sparkly and fun. So what a wonderful thing to know that our families were planned by God. It just didn't happen. You see, before the foundation of the world, you were planned by God, as was your family, who would be your children, your grandchildren, your great-grandchildren. I think it's so cool because they are a shine and a sparkle. And I love it because the base of a crown is a circle, which means families are forever. I love that. And so I think, let's see. Megan brought sparkle into Benny's life when he visited your family living in California. Because her first steps she walked to her grandpa. And he had so much fun playing with the kids that he ran into the door and broke. I just wanted to share that with you, that how wonderful that is, how we belong to God and how he has a plan. The rest of that scripture is children's children are a crown to the elderly. And the last part is, and the fathers are the glory of the children. Now, what does that mean? That means they express the love, the trust, the thing that makes children feel secure is their father. And as I understand it, Benny was afraid of water. He always wore a life jacket. Is that correct? I think his mother warned him or something. Something like that. So he was always careful about that. But there was a time by the ocean when Anne wanted to go in the ocean. And she was afraid to go. But Benny walked out in the ocean with her. And that made her feel secure, like she could do that. He laid aside his fears for her, and they walked out into the ocean together. Colossians 3:20-25 says this: whatever you do, work with it with all your heart, as though God was right there, because he is watching. And that's what Bernie did. Whatever he did it meticulously. I guess he even made his own bed at the hospital. He just did whatever he saw that needed to be done. And he did it with all of his heart. What a blessing. And God is watching. God is watching. When Bernie and Russ went to, I think you were living in South Dakota, but you went to a place called T, South Dakota. And they went there to paint a house, okay? While they were there for 1 week, they painted 12 or 13 houses. And I guess Russ had to, he got to do all this. Russ, is that right? And then he did all the trim, you know, took care of everything. They worked together. And then Chris and his dad built 3 duplexes out to Sleepy Hollow. How many know where Sleepy Hollow is? Yeah, it's out at the end of Center and whatever that Santa Claus or whatever it is. So they built out there. So the guys worked with their dad. And what's incredible? See, that's another trait that has been passed on generational besides chasing storms. Because now we have Ben, and we have Chris, and we have Nate. It's wonderful how that is passed on down through the generations. Well, if you notice the house on the corner of 6th and Church Street, it is green, yellow, with white trim, okay? Benny's 88 years old, and he's painting that house. They actually tied 2 ladders together so he could get up high enough to paint the trim. And he did a beautiful job. But I thought about the scripture where God said he sent angels, command angels, to come and take care of people when they were doing things like that.
Yeah.
And God took care of him. But he did a beautiful job. Whatever he did with all of his heart. He did it wholly as unto the Lord. And God rewarded him for that. I understood that two families came to Benny. And they wanted their house painted. But they couldn't afford it. And Benny said, I'm bored anyway. I might as well paint their houses for them. So he painted 2 homes for people that could not afford to pay for it. Isn't that wonderful? A giving heart, always doing what he could. Not too long before Benny passed away, he was at the hospital, and I went to visit him. And I asked him about his faith in Jesus, about his faith in God. And we talked about that, we prayed. He said, yes, I really believe. He said, do you want to hear about my miracle? And I said, sure. And he shared with me that he was carrying a bundle of shingles, dropped them on his toe, and it bled profusely. And the guys working with him said, don't you think you need to go get to the doctor for that? He said, no, I'm just asking God to heal it. And God did. It stopped bleeding immediately. His sock was soaked in blood, but his foot was healed. don't really know them. You don't know all these things, but I want to tell you something. God's interested in what's going on in your heart. And Benny's heart was toward God, was toward others. I want to share with you also, he was a good cook. He was a good cook. And could he ever pop popcorn? I mean, it was the best, you know, with the kind of turn the handle. He had to do it just right. When Marilyn, his wife, was in the care center, he took her out every evening for a meal, or else he prepared a meal and took it out to the care center. The scripture tells us in Ephesians that a man should love his wife like he loves himself. I found that so incredible to think that he did that. He probably had painted all day lots of times or done some kind of construction. But Marilyn still was his wife that he cared for. What's incredible, he also fed the nurses. And I guess cream corn and cream peas and whatever he cooked was just out of this world. So what a heart. That's what God honors. And you know what? It was a day, the 17th of March, that his journey on earth was over. And that will happen for all of us. Be at peace when they lay me down. My spirit will rise. Do you know we'll all have that day when we lay down this life? Mm-hmm. And we'll enter into eternity. Benny did that on the 17th of the month. And what's most important is that we know where we're going. Tomorrow's Good Friday, the day that was good for us, but not good for Jesus. It was the day that he laid down his life for us. And I think about it. been telling his disciples he was going to leave. He'd been telling his disciples in the 14th chapter of John that I'm going to be leaving, but I will come back. And Peter said, you're not going anywhere. You know, Peter, he was always going to help. I will defend you. Nobody's going to take you away. But Jesus said, I'm going to leave, but I will come again. And so in that 14th chapter of John, Jesus said this, let not your trouble, don't be troubled, believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that there you may be also. And Thomas said, Lord, we don't know where you're going, and we don't even know how to get there. And Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one cometh unto the Father but by me. And you know that's true. We know the scripture, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him would not perish but have everlasting life. That's the key to heaven. You know, we say, well, if I do enough good works, I'll go. If I go to church enough, if I do all these good things, that's enough. It's wonderful. And you need to go to church. And you need to be kind. You need the gifts of charity. But it's all about the blood of Jesus. If Jesus had not shed his blood, we, none of us, could go to heaven. And so we sometimes think, well, I'll wait this out. If I'm my good deeds are more than my bad deeds, then well, this will be good. But if that were the case, Jesus would not have died for us. Why would God give the best that heaven had, and then we would reject it and say, I'll just get by. I'll just get by. It's appointed unto one man once to die. And there's no other name given under heaven whereby men must be saved. So, Jesus said he was the way, the truth, and the life. We don't know the way. Hey, it's a good shepherd way. It's the way that he directs us. Gently, kindly. And you know, when we do wrong, God is never like this. I am so angry. It's like this. Come on. Let's be partners. I love you. It's for grace are we saved through faith. Not of ourselves. It is a gift from God. We open our heart to Jesus, and he comes in, and he's our partner. He's our good shepherd. I love the scripture in Revelation, the 3rd chapter, that says, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man will hear my voice and open the door, I will come in and sup with him, and he with me. I think about that word sup. Makes me think, I'll come in and have supper with you. Talk around the table like we did the other night. I want to know how you feel. I want to help you with what you're going through. And sometimes we don't want to do that. We want to do things our own. But Jesus is the one, the truth. I love it because life is forever. Hey, we decrease. Things change. As much as I want to be like I was 5 years ago, it's not that way. But God has something better planned for us. The Then he's gone on to his eternal rewards, and we have ours in front of us. Let's just let Jesus be our good shepherd and lead us through life. Your life will be so much better. Will everything be perfect? No, life's not perfect. You go through hard times. But when you have the good shepherd, you don't go through him alone. He's there to give you strength and your joy. So today, I'm just asking, really think about Easter. Really think about tomorrow, Good Friday. And think about that you can have eternal life in a much better place than this. The scripture says, eye has not seen, ear has not heard. We can't even imagine the things that God has prepared for those that love him. And I'm grateful there's no old age in heaven. We'll all be brand new. The scripture says, behold, I make all things new. Tells us that we are his own, and there's really joy in knowing that. I think about a scene at the tomb where Jesus is risen, and Mary Magdalene had gone early on the first day of the week to put spices on the body, and the angel said, he's not here, he's risen. And then we find later, just a few hours, because they were supposed to go tell the disciples, Mary goes back to the tomb, and she stooped down, and she's looking in, and she's weeping. And she said, where have you taken my Lord that I may go take care of his body? And she's supposing him to be the guard, saying, where did you take my Lord? And he said, Mary. And when he said, Mary, she recognized it was the voice of Jesus. And she said, Master, I want you to know Jesus knows your name. I want you to, I you are alive, you're seated at the right hand of the Father, and you even pray for us. Thank you, Jesus. Now open our hearts, help us to open our hearts to you and receive your love and your fellowship. In Jesus' name, amen. I want to share one more thing with you, and I'm doing this because this is a generational thing. This is something my dad did. He said, I want you to take a walk down memory lane and pick for yourself the most beautiful bouquet of memories that you can find. Because you have them, kids. You have them. All of us have them with family. Pick that bouquet of flowers. Oh, don't forget to pick the Rose of Sharon and put that in the middle of your bouquet, because that represents Jesus, and that's why you have what you have. That's why you have your memories. And then put it in the special place, we used to say, on the mantle of your heart. Not many mantles anymore, but wherever, set it in your heart. And go back there often and remember how blessed that you are, that Benny is in your life, and how blessed we are that we can know Jesus and we can have a good memory and look forward to being together again. God bless you.